Hi, and welcome to 4-Minute Answers. If you have a database of projects, or perhaps a database of tasks within a project, you have the ability to show this in what Notion calls a timeline view. Timeline view is a super-powered version of a Gantt chart, a way to lay out your projects or your tasks along a time continuum. In this video, we'll show you how to create your timeline view and the ease of working with it, how to customize your timeline view, and ways to use it to make you even more productive. First, let's start with a simple database. I've created a sample database of projects related to buying and running an investment property. Most projects have dates connected to them, and for a timeline view, you need to have dates. For timeline views and for real-life project management, it is useful to have both a start date and a due date. After all, most projects don't just get done in one day, so planning your start and finish is helpful. Now, go up to the toggle and add Create a New View and select Timeline View. Automatically, it lays out your projects and spreads them over the dates from each project's start date to due date. As you look at this, you have an easy visualization of all your projects and how they lay out, and whether you have some times where there is too much going on and other times where there is too little. If you have a large project database that has business and personal projects or projects that are for specific clients, you can filter your view to show you only the projects you want to see, or you can remove the view and see all of them. You can also sort your projects alphabetically, start date, due date, or by any property your projects have. You can either leave that sort there, or if you want to use it as a starting point and then change from there, you can then just drag projects up and down to where you want them. If you want to group all personal projects together, therefore, it's easy to do. It will ask you if you want to remove the sort, and you do, but Notion leaves the projects where it was last sorted. Just grab what you want and move it. A great aspect of Timeline View is that you can easily change the start or due date, or both, easily just by moving the project along the timeline view, or by grabbing one end of it and stretching it or compressing it to whatever dates you need. As you do that, it adjusts the dates on the specific project's page so that that change carries through any reference it has throughout all of your Notion. Now up at the top right, you can set the amount of time you want to see in your timeline, all the way from annually to hourly. For me, I'm looking more at the monthly to annual views for projects, but you could use timeline view to run your daily or weekly plan or a calendar, and then the hourly view is useful. Of course, for this, your specific projects would need to have start and finish times as well. So let's talk about some additional ways to customize this view. We set up your basic timeline view, and we've filtered and sorted it, and we've adjusted the dates as needed, but what else can we do to make this really useful? By default, on the desktop view, Notion shows the project list on the left. You can choose to get rid of that, since the project names are listed in the timeline view itself. On mobile, that default is to not have that project list on the left. You can also decide what other properties you want displayed next to the project name. For example, if you want a checkbox that you can indicate if it's complete or not, you can add that. Just click on the three dots at the top right of the timeline and select the properties you want displayed in your timeline. And those properties will be added to the right of the name of the project in your view. Any property you have for your projects can be reflected here. Now, one of the things I like to do is to add a property to my projects for whether a project is on time, at risk, or late, and then I can reflect that on my timeline view. It's just helpful to know where I need to put my attention. Now, it's actually easy to do if you use either a red, yellow, or green icon for each of your projects. However, if you like your icons as they are, you can easily create a property that you can use color on. For example, I can simply use the plus sign for on time and color that green, the minus sign for late and color that red, and an exclamation point for at risk and color that yellow. Now I can just add that property type and it shows up next to the project name. For me, the timeline view is my default view for my project list. In one glance, it communicates important details about a project in the context of all the other projects going on, and I can make my date adjustments super easily. One thing to note is that Notion says that it limits the number of timeline views for a free or personal plan. What isn't clear is how they count that. For example, I keep all my projects on a master project list, and then I have properties for whether they are personal, professional, or side hustle. And then in each of my dashboards, I can use that database and filter it on a personal, professional, or side hustle. I can do that with timeline view. Use a timeline view in my master project database, and then do a linked database using timeline view in all of the filtered areas. But it isn't clear to me whether this counts as one timeline view toward Notion's limit or four. But at least for now, it appears to work great. How are you using timeline views? Drop a comment below and then check out another 4-Minute Answer video right here.